Hi, welcome to my next video. This time I wanted to show you something a bit different. As you know, some time ago I was forced to close my print store. The webshop that I was using for selling signed prints, Ticktail, was bought by a bigger company that I didn't like so much, so I decided to close this shop temporarily. And from that time I was looking for a new partner, for a new place to use to sell not only signed prints but also signed books and stickers and tote bags and all kinds of stuff. And I think I finally found a place like this that I can use. But before I start making and selling the goods and making the store public, I have to customize the design of the website. So for this I need a banner, a nice new banner that I can put on the top of the page. To design it, to decide the idea, to decide what I want to put in it, I did first few really simple sketches just with my pencil on a paper pad not bigger than 8 centimeters to figure out what I will paint. I used some photos of cute European shops like bookstores that I found on Pinterest, but other than that I didn't have any direct reference. I just knew that I want to have a nice shop in the front, my logo big in the middle, and then I wanted the background to just disappear into the distance, into whiteness, so the whole banner will work well with the design of the website, which has a white background. When I had the contents decided, I just made a photo of the sketch with my iPad and imported this file to my Procreate project, which has the exact dimensions of the banner that I need, just 2 times bigger to be safe. I wanted to paint the whole thing with Procreate this time. The first step was to make a line art, a quite detailed one. I wanted to know the exact shape of things, so even though these lines will not be featured in the final illustration, I wanted it to be quite exact. Then I started to fill in all the shapes. I used a different layer for each shape, for each color, so they don't overlap, and I can edit them, add textures to them, change their colors independently later. This is a method that I like to use with complicated scenes when I'm painting digitally. Even with animation backgrounds where we had a lot of details and a lot of layers, I used this method to block in the shapes before I started painting with the final colors. With this picture I didn't want to put too many details in, not to make it too realistic, so it doesn't overcrowd the design of the page. After all the shapes were filled with temporary colors and the layers were locked, I started to add textures, modify the colors to match the final look I was aiming for. Also, the last step was to add some light effects, like light streaks from the right side and a bit of white light in the distance, to make the logo look more prominent and to make the background disappear into the whiteness like I wanted. Overall, this was a really fun illustration for me to paint, a simple thing in a style that I didn't use for some time, so it was fresh, and I could also do it from start to finish on my iPad and show it to you. Okay, so this is how the illustration looks like after it's finished, and I did some color correction with filters like curves to make it brighter and to make it pop a bit more on the design of the website. I also like how the banner looks like when the right side is disappearing to a white background. Okay, that's it for this video. As always, feel free to comment, share and subscribe, and you can also support me on Patreon. I will announce the opening of this store on all my accounts, but you can still use my Society 6 store as usual. It is not changing and has a lot of prints there that you can buy. You can also download the Procreate brushes that I used in this video on my Gumroad store. Okay, that's it. See you in the next one. Bye!